I'm gonna open the, this public hearing, by stating that, this is for the deck expansion at Northampton Brewery, 11 Brewster Court, Northampton, map ID 32C-2829. It was advertised on December 24th and December 31st. We're gonna start with, public comment on any other item not otherwise on the agenda, and then we'll move right into the presentation. Are there any public comments? Mr. Austin, would you like to present?
Sure. My name is Bill Austin, Austin Design. I'm the architect for this project. Jerry Shattuck is the builder. Janet Eggleston, as I'm sure you all know, is the owner. Her husband, Mitch, is here. He's going to be speaking about the sign a little bit. And then Donald Patcher, the brewmaster. I don't know that you'll have any comments, but we'll see. So what I brought is essentially a slightly updated set of drawings to the ones that you have there. Do you want to just really restrict it to the deck, or do you want a quick run through of the whole project?
Our overview is really the exterior of the building.
Okay. Well, then bear with me while I flip through this. So anyway, this is for reference. There it is. This is the site plan. This is the deck extension that we're talking about right there. There's also, you'll see in the illustration, there's going to be a new awning across the face here, which will be within the setback, not the setback, but the property line. This is basically the interior. The old bar is coming out, a new bar is going in. There'll be new banquette seating, and then what's driving this is a new open kitchen with a pizza oven, rotisserie, and whatnot. And then, because of the change in laws, the brewery can now be open to the public, so we now have interior access. And a big, big part of this project is really just infrastructure work across the board, but particularly the brewery. So, currently, this is the roof deck, as it is. This is the second floor mezzanine. We're adding right here. That's the deck extension in question. Is there any questions? No? This is a elevation of the south side, or the Hampton Ave side. So there is the deck. Two-thirds of the deck extension will have an awning, which will be identical to the awnings that were put up back in 1995. We will be rebuilding the fence across the front at this point, probably doing a corrugated steel, something which is fairly indestructible. And there'll be access to the the recycling trash area. This is the awning structure, as we talked about. Portions of it will be covered in the same awning material for shade and whatnot, seasonal planters. Three large new windows and doors. These two are windows are fixed. This will be operable to allow servicing of the tanks inside as necessary. This is a view from the west side. So here again, from this point over is the deck extension. There's the awning extension. There will be an exhaust vent in approximately that area. So the vents which are currently in this area will be going away.
The fencing that you are showing here, you have fencing there now, is
yeah.
that right? It's wood?
Wood.
Somewhere.
Yeah.
There's a photograph on the front page.
Yeah, you can see the fences. Okay. So here are some renderings. So again, you can see the new fence material. This all sits back a few inches from the property line so that the excavation for the new posts and whatnot can be done without going over the property line. So everything's just tucked back a little bit. This will be the new sign right here. And if you want details, Mitch are ready to describe what that'll be all about.
Sure.
Mitch, do you want to take a minute and talk about it?
The sign's going to be a very simple design. It's a 2x12 sign that is kind of tucked in between the railing of the upper deck and the roof. The sign is partially going to be obscured, you know, from either direction when you're driving up to it, but its main purpose is, you know, as you're just going onto the brewery, you'll be able to see a smaller size 2x12 sign that says brewery, and it'll be in red neon. Basic construction, just stainless steel, tubing type steel, with letters on both sides that say brewery, and lit up in red neon.
So right now it looks like you can see through it, but you wouldn't actually see through it because it would be in different directions on different sides?
It's actually, with the stainless steel and the glass tubes, it's going to have a transparent quality to it. So it's not going to be, it's not big and bulky or anything. It's going to have, you're not going to be able to see through it, but you will be able to see the, you know, the letters. Mostly you'll be able to see the stainless steel during the day, and the neon will be more apparent at night.
I guess my question was, can you only read it in one direction correctly?
No, it'll be, you'll be able to read it in both directions.
Okay.
The framing on it will be like a box type stainless steel tube framing,
mm-hmm.
and letters will be made brewery on one side, and different letters will be made brewery on the other side with like a separation in the middle.
I think that's your suggestion. There's like a plane between it, so like you won't see both sets of letters, so you can visually confused with the light.
Right. You won't see both sets of letters. The back side of the neon tubes are painted with this black coating to prevent the light from going from one direction to the other.
I like how they hover right now.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's computer magic right now.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Just some shots, renderings of the deck. There's the new exhaust vent. This structure is a weight station. The new deck extension is back beyond that plane. This is what you see when you immediately get to the top of the stairs. The bar, which is currently over here, gets relocated to this area over here. It's just a view looking back, you know, from the deck along the edge where the overhang of the greenhouse is. And then another view.
You're not required to provide any accessibility to all that space up there?
We are, and it's not shown, but we have a list. That was, part of the permitting. Really, nothing that's of interest to you guys. Then just some interior rendering showing the new bar, the pizza oven in the back there, some new glass racks, and whatnot. Views of the same area. Definitely not interesting material. The deck will have, this is showing where some of the old railing currently is. We're going to be adding wood slatting to it in areas where privacy will be a concern. And then the deck extension itself will have the vertical pipe railing and the top rail for strength, but it will have just wood slats. And again, it's a privacy issue. That's it.
What is the roof covering over the that you have over the canopy that's on the street side?
The building canopy.
Yeah, the building canopy.
The arch canopy in the
right.
Front. Yeah, it's ultimately Janet's choice. My understanding is we'll be using the same material that we're using on the canopies up above.
Which is?
Canvas.
Fabric.
It's canvas.
It's fabric.
Canvas,
yeah.
Okay, it's not loose side or steel.
No, not semi-seam
the not plastic, yeah.
Is that some kind of, I'm sure.
Canvas.
Yeah.
Any questions? I have a couple of questions. One, looking, this is a perfect view right here where you can see the dumpsters. Maybe those aren't even your dumpsters. I was hopeful that maybe the new fencing would hide the dumpsters.
Those are, yeah, not ours.
I noticed that this is also a good view. You can see where the existing exhaust hoods are, which are not very attractive. And so those go away and they get, there's a new hood that goes up.
Correct.
And I know one of the things in the central business architecture guidelines is about not being able to see mechanical equipment from the street, but this is certainly much less visible and it's not a roof structure, so I don't think that would apply. And then my last question was, the signage is very cool looking. Is there any limits to size on signage, and do we...
It is. It's under the zoning or zoning board as opposed to central business. So there's a maximum of 10% of the front floor facade or 100 square feet. I forget what the number is, but I think it was far below the 10. It was around even less than 10%, I think.
Well, I think so. I mean, I think if we, the way we ran the numbers conservatively, we would have allowed 100 square feet, but this is about 2 by 12, so we're at 25 square feet, something like that. So it's far more what would be allowed, but still a substantial size.
And we also have, right now, we have a limit on the amount you can project from the front wall, and this is within that. You're allowed to project up to a foot without going triggering special permit to the zoning board. So they're even within the by right projection standards for sign.
Overall, I think it's going to be a great improvement to the building and add some liveliness on that side of the street. You have so much on the other side of the building, and this will just add to that. I think it's a great project visually. It's in line with what's already existing in terms of the deck and canopies. I like how the front facade is getting all tied together with more canopies. I just think overall just pulls the whole building and project together. I think it's a great project.
Yeah, I think it's very friendly to the street there, and I think that's good. That'll enhance the streetscape in that area. Again, to me, it's in the category of what's not to like. No, I think it looks pretty good. You guys did a good job.
Would anybody like to make a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve the project as presented.
Close the hearing first, then, or go simultaneously.
Yeah. And want to make a motion to close the hearing?
So moved.
Second.
A motion to approve.
We all have to say aye first.
Right? Oh, all in favor, sorry. We haven't been in the meeting for a while. All in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed?
Now I'd like to make a motion to approve the project as presented and echo Alan and Bruce's sentiments that this is really a great addition to the downtown and to Hampton.
Anyone like to second that?
I'll second that.
All in favor? No opposed? Okay. Great.
Even though we just approved this, the large stack, no, that large, like, round circular steam jack, is that the exhaust for the all the kitchen now? And everything, the brewery exhausts and all that is all?
Everything goes into that one thing. And then, yeah, it's a long story you don't want to hear, but yes, we are bringing all of the ducts together, and then we're going to be sheathing them in some kind of shell that'll serve as insulation and stabilization. So, you know,
yeah. Well, I'm just curious. In the rendering, it just kind of shows it open at the top. I was just curious to how you were exhausting all those things without covers over the.
That's a rendering.
They're inside.
They're inside, and there will be, you know, sort of typical of that type of stack. There'll be some kind of, you know, hat-shaped chimney cover so we don't get rain down the stacks and whatnot.
Right, that's what I was curious about.
Yeah.
I'd like to make a motion to adjourn the meeting.
Can we do minutes?
Oh, sorry. But we can let these folks.
Yes, if they're all set.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Do you want another thing?
Me too.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
It's cold.
Buy a couple months of money here.
Are you shut down now completely?
2 months. As Bill said, deferred maintenance kind of all over the place, it's just kind of fitting and just running the mechanical.
So are you salvaging that nice center barbies?
I did, absolutely.
Where is that going?
It's going to Mitch's man. What was the next to sell the shoe? No, that's a great piece. Bob and I worked together on the original construction.
How many moons ago?
Did you work with John Tierney and Mary Johnson?
Oh, sure, yeah.
John Tierney's my father.
Hey, is that right? Oh, yeah. That's great, yeah.
I was going to say, Don, did you go outside now?
So much of the original bones of what is now the building is.
Well, have fun with the project.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you. Thanks again. Take care.
So we have September 10th and August 22nd, so we really have a mess. I briefly went through them. One of the meetings I wasn't at, so you can still vote to accept them, even though you weren't. I'm sorry, I don't have them in front of me. Okay. Yeah, so September 10th was the Academy of Music Firescape.
Yes.
And the August 22nd was the modification to the Center Street restaurant building. It was an amendment to the original permit.
Correct. So I have a motion to approve the minutes for August 22nd.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
And can I have a motion to approve the September meeting minutes?
So I make a motion to approve the minutes.
Second.
All in favor?
Yeah, the Center Street restaurant stuff is coming out pretty nicely.
Yeah. It's taking forever, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they're going to have a slot this
year. That's been going on for, what, 2 or 3 years?
But it's really tight together.
It's going to be very attractive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I talked to Paul Serio every once in a while. Apparently they're waiting for some of the windows to be fabricated for that older section where it used to be the restaurant there. And once they get those, they'll pop on in at the end of the way.
But does he have a tenant?
He didn't say anything about that. I didn't push him.
Can I make a motion to adjourn the meeting?
First, I would like to mention one thing that, you know, that I serve on the City's Historical Commission, and for our annual Historic Preservation Awards, one of them that we gave was not only to police station, which went through vigorous reviews by this particular committee, and also for the, what is it, the Northampton coffee shop down here where the facade was rebuilt. And that went, again, that went through this committee, but the Historical Commission felt that both of those projects, one as, in effect, a reconstruction of a historic structure, and the other, construction of a new building that really contributed to the historic character of the town, were both important to recognize. And we had the presentations of McFadden's, Irish pub,
McLadden's,
which was delightful, McLadden's.
McFadden's is
absolutely delightful. And so hopefully more projects coming through here of that character might attract the attention of the historical. Sadly, we didn't get that much publicity in the Gazette about it, but there it goes.
Not much anything in the Gazette anymore.
Okay.
Now, ready?
So moved.
All in favor? Done.